So did you take history in grade 11? Did you learn anything about Cleopatra in that class? No?
In grade 10.
In grade 10 you did, okay. When you learned about Cleopatra in grade 10, did they teach you how she came into power?
No.
Do you know how she came into power? Or just guess? You can guess.
I have no idea. She married Mark Anthony?
But was she taught in school at all, ever?
Not much.
Not much?
A couple times.
But what they did say about her, do you know how she came into power?
I know that her father was a pharaoh.
Mm-hmm.
And
that's it? Did you learn about Egypt in grade 10?
Yeah.
Did you guys learn a little bit about Cleopatra?
No. Well, maybe a little bit, but okay. Not much.
All right.
It was more about hieroglyphs and mummies.
All right. Do you know how she came into power? Take a guess if you don't know.
Born into power?
Do you know how she rose to power?
Using her body? Because I heard she presented herself to King Alexander as a gift.
You guys are just rubbing your boobs.
Cleopatra?
What did you learn about her?
Not much. I did an essay. History essay.
And what did you focus on about her?
Mostly her relationship with the Mark Anthony guy.
Okay. So nothing.
And how they pretty much. Something about like their ruling not being good enough to support them. Like they all die. Basically.
Do you know how she came into power?
She married Julius Caesar. And she was also part of a monarchy. That's wrong.
Okay.
Because she was part of, you know, the whole Egyptian monarchy and all that.
Yeah.
And she used her. She wasn't really good looking, from what I've heard.
Yeah.
But she used her power of
sexuality?
Yeah, sexuality to dominate over Julius Caesar, who was like, what, 30 years old?
So would you say that she was loose?
A little bit, but you know, for good, she had good intentions.
If you move too quick, oh well.
history has been told. If we look at the ancient historians, they're men. So therefore, it has a male bias to it. A lot of women are left out, and the role that women play in history are left out. We tend to focus on war and politics. And right up into the 19th, 20th century, women were kept out of those roles. So because of that, you do not see a... not an existence, but you don't see enough talked about. It's not to say that women weren't involved behind the scenes, but it's not written about in the history books. So,
is there any famous historical women that you would think could apply to your subject area that you would like to teach about, that people should know about?
Yeah, well, there's many. We do talk about them. I wouldn't say that I give them personally enough coverage. A lot of that has to do with a lack of knowledge or a lack of exposure. That is, that blame can be put on myself for not doing that. We do look at the role that women played in certain aspects of society, especially when we get into the 1920s. We look at, there are mention of female roles, as in we talk about Florence Nightingale during the Industrial Revolution. I talk about Madame de Staël during the French Revolution. I talk about Mary Wollstonecraft. Those are women that will come up in my class, but that is not even scratching the surface.
And do you feel that the absence of kind of women in history and how it's all his story, does that affect students in any way? Do you see that effect?
Yeah, I do. Some of my best students are girls, but I get the sense that because there's not enough positive role models for them, they lose interest in history over time. It tends to be dominated by males, and therefore they do tend to take an interest in it. We are starting to see a change at university. You will see an opportunity to take courses that focus on the role of women in society and the role of women in history and politics. And I think that will drag more in. But as far as public education is concerned, we look at the way the curriculum is designed, I think we do women a disservice in the history curriculums.
Well, that's all the questions I have for you. Is there any closing thoughts you'd like to add?
I guess you kind of put me on the spot there. Not really, I guess. We all have to take a responsibility for this, so I don't want to put the blame on the government by any means. I'm as responsible as the next person for not giving it enough focus, I guess. So I put too much pressure on my students to do that for me, and I guess I need to be the one that to bring forth in class.